Beim Klettern kann es auch zu
Climbing can also result in spinal injuries. These mostly occur as a result of falls on easy routes. That's to say, where a victim suffers several impacts, tumbling head over heels, and in so doing, causes injury to the spine.
The spine surrounds the delicate spinal cord with its many nerve fibers that connect the brain to the body. The spinal cord can be damaged by broken or displaced vertebrae, or even by swelling in the area. Approximately 75% of spinal injuries are painless and result in no loss of function. This means individuals affected are not aware they have displaced or broken vertebrae. Only after further movement does the accident victim become aware of the occasional twinge. This is where a quick examination of the body can be particularly useful. For the 75% of spinal injuries that result in no pain or loss of function, palpation of the spine from top to bottom should be carried out. Palpation causes pressure pain or a feeling of discomfort. If this is the case, err on the side of caution. Assume the injury is serious and call emergency services. For the remaining 25% of cases, damage to the spine results directly in loss of function at the time of the fall. These individuals will experience a tingling sensation or even numbness in the legs or hands. They'll have problems with motor functions, so they'll have difficulty moving their arms, hands, feet, or legs. And when you touch the skin, it will feel to them like someone touching them through cotton wool. In this case, it is vital to call emergency services immediately. People with a spinal injury who are still conscious should be moved as little as possible. The exception to this is if you're in an acute danger zone, such as a rock fall area. Here, regardless of the injury, the individual must be lifted and removed from the danger zone as quickly as possible. If the accident victim is on safe ground, movement should be kept to a minimum. However, efforts should be made to minimize heat loss and maintain spinal alignment. This means laying the victim out flat so the spine is straight. Should a person with a spinal injury lose consciousness, life-saving emergency measures take absolute priority, so make sure to check breathing. If the accident victim is breathing, put them in the stable recovery position. If they are no longer breathing, begin resuscitation. For this, the individual will have to be turned. This should be done with great care. Accident victims with a spinal injury will be very concerned that they may suffer paralysis. So, good psychological support is extremely important. The better the support from the first responder, the better and calmer the state of the accident victim when they're handed over to the rescue services.